Dr. Neha Taneja. Today we'll be talking about normal distribution. This is a very important question both for your university as well as for your entrance examination. So let us begin. Now, what is normal distribution? Normal distribution, I've written down for you, is it denotes or it reflects the features of distribution of observations around the mean. What does it mean? That in a set of data, how my observations are distributed around the central value or the mean. What are the characteristics of that distribution? What are the features of that distribution? That is reflected by normal distribution. There are other terms for normal distribution. It is also called as Gaussian distribution, also called as standard distribution. This was named after Carl Gauss, who was a mathematician. So if you're asked, other than normal distribution, if you see terms like Gaussian or standard, don't get confused. It is for normal distribution only. Now, second question, why is it called normal? What is normal about it? So it is in a normal distribution, it is so called normal because for a set of data, most of the values or the observations are clustered around the mean value. And only relatively a fewer values will deviate on the extremes on either side. So what is this normal thing? The normal thing is that most of the values are clustered around the central value. Hence, it is known as normal distribution. Of features of normal distribution, which is asked as MCQ, so we'll discuss those features one by one. Feature of a normal distribution is, number one, what is the shape of normal distribution? So they ask you the shape. They give you an option, is it linear, is it hyperbola? So the shape of a normal distribution is, it is bell shape. What do you understand by this? So let us take an example. Suppose there are a class of 50 students. We take examples of weight of students in the class. Okay. So somebody's weight would be 20, 30, 40, 50. So if you draw a curve, if the data is normally distributed, it will come out to be this. This way. Okay. So this is what is known as bell shape. What does bell shape indicate? That the frequencies, they taper off very rapidly, smoothly, and on either side. Okay. The second point is that it is bilaterally symmetrical. Now, what do you mean by this bilaterally symmetrical? That means that suppose I drop a perpendicular from the central point here towards the base. Okay. You will see that this curve is divided exactly into two halves. That is, 50% of the values are above this line and 50% of the values are below this line. That means what? That this side of the curve is exactly a mirror image of this side of the curve. So both reflect each other. That is the meaning of bilaterally symmetric. The third point is that there is a point of coincidence in a normal distribution. What is this point of coincidence? That point is this point. That is, this point for a normal distribution reflects mean equal to median equal to mode. So, in a normal distribution, mean is equal to median is equal to mode. That is, all these three coincide. This is a feature of normal distribution. Okay. Is 1 or 100%. Now, I told you this is bilaterally symmetrical. So, this entire area can either be taken as 1 or 50-50%. It will be 100%. Okay. Now, the third point. The fifth point, which is asked as an MCQ. They will give you that for a normal distribution, which of the options are correct? They will write that mean equal to 1, SD equal to 0, or mean equal to 0, SD equal to 1, or mean equal to infinite, SD equal to 0, or something else, mean equal to 0, SD equal to 0. So out of this, for a normal distribution, which is the correct option? So I'll make you understand that. Now suppose this central value, if we take at this value mean is equal to median is equal to mode. Now suppose that value is 0, which practically is not possible because mean weight of 100 students in a class cannot be 0 kg. Mean hemoglobin of 100 students in a class cannot be 0 gram per deciliter. So we will just assume that suppose in this central point the mean is equal to 0. Okay. Now what does standard deviation reflect? It reflects the dispersion of individual values on both sides of the mean. So if this value is 0, 50% of values are dispersed to the right and 50% to the left. 50% could be, that would be equal to what? 0.5 and 0.5. So what will be the total standard deviation? It will be nothing but 0.5 plus 0.5, which will be 1. So what is my correct option here? For a normal distribution, mean is equal to 0 and standard deviation is equal to 1. Okay? Now moving ahead, this point or the feature of normal distribution curve, it is, there are points of inflection. This can be asked to you as MCQ. What does this inflection denote? Now here if you look at the curve, this part of the curve is convex. Okay? Now where this curve from convex changes to concavity is the point of inflection. Okay, now there is an importance of this point of inflection. So point of inflection means convexity of curve changes to concavity, the point. Now what is the importance of this point? It is very simple. Suppose you draw a perpendicular from this here. Okay, similarly from here, this side. This perpendicular, okay, this perpendicular will divide this base or it will cut this base at a distance of, very important, please listen, it will cut this base or it will divide this base at a distance of 1 SD from the mean on either side. Okay, so if you dropped a perpendicular here and here from this point of inflection, this will cut the base at a distance of 1 SD on either side from the mean. Okay. Similarly, if you drop another perpendicular here and here, okay, this will cut your base exactly at a distance of 2 SD on either side from the mean. Okay. Similarly, another point, this will cut your base at a distance of exactly 3 SD from the mean. Do you understand now? And I have written this term for you, that mean plus minus 1 standard deviation covers 68.3% of the values. Mean plus minus 2 standard deviation covers 95.4% of values. And mean plus minus 3 standard deviation covers 99.7% of values. So you do not need to remember the decimal points. You can simply remember mean plus minus 1 SD covers 68% of values. Mean plus minus 2 SD covers 95% of values. And mean plus minus 3 SD covers 99% of values. Because this is asked in an MCQ. And this better, I put down a question for you which comes as an MCQ. Suppose in a class there are 50 students and mean hemoglobin follows a normal distribution. So as soon as they say normal distribution, you should remember all these points. Okay? The standard deviation is 3 grams. So question would be 95% of students' hemoglobin will lie between dash and dash. So as soon as you see the question, you see it is 95%. So what formula should go with you? Mean plus minus 2 SD covers 95% of the value. So you put here mean plus minus 2 SD covers 95%. So the mean here is 12 plus minus 2 into 3. So that is 6. So this will cover 95% of the value. So this is what my examiner is asking me, that 95% of students' hemoglobin will lie between 12 plus minus 6 gram per deciliter. Okay, these are asked as MCQs. Now if you notice, the last point for a normal distribution curve is that the tails are never touching the line. What does that mean? That means that if I ask you that what percent of standard deviation Okay, percent of standard deviation will cover 100% of values. Okay, like here mean plus 2 plus minus 2 SD covers 95, mean plus minus 3 covers 99.7. So what percent of SD will cover 100% of values? So guys, the answer to this is infinite. If you keep on doing this, okay, mean plus minus 4 SD will cover 99.77% values. Mean plus minus 5 SD will cover 99.87, like this. So this will never give you an exact value. It's infinite percentage of standard deviations cover this much. So therefore, the tails are never touching the base. This was the thing that you should know. So just to revise, for a normal distribution, the curve is bell-shaped. It is bilaterally symmetrical. There is a point of coincidence where mean equal to median is equal to mode. All the three coincide. The area under the curve is 1 or 100%. If mean is 0, standard deviation will be equal to 1. And these three values you need to remember. Mean plus minus 1 SD covers 68% values. Mean plus minus 2 SD covers 95%. And mean plus minus 3 SD covers 99% of values. And the tails of the curve are never touching the base. So I hope I made you clear. Any comments, put on the comment section below. And come again with another video. Thank you so much.